Early yesterday morning, just after midnight, a major landslide occurred in British Columbia within Canada, resulting in the loss of a tent and raft and injuring one person. However, this landslide created a much bigger problem, resulting in mandatory evacuations for areas up to 31.3 kilometers or 19.4 miles away. The reason for such a wide-ranging evacuation area is that this landslide, which I estimate contained a volume of 9.31 million cubic meters of rock that collapsed from a nearly quarter square kilometer patch of ground, has completely blocked a major regional river, specifically the Chilcotin River. In the more than 36 hours since, water has pooled behind the temporary natural earthen dam, forming a more than 3-kilometer-long lake, which is more than 20 meters deep, with some unconfirmed reports alleging it is now more than 60 meters or 197 feet deep. As this vast mass of water continues to pool behind the landslide deposit, increasing pressure is being applied to it, which almost certainly will eventually trigger a catastrophic collapse. Such a collapse could cause a major flood and wall of water to burst downstream, possibly affecting certain towns more than 200 kilometers away. As a result, not only is a 65.2 kilometer long stretch of the Chilcotin River and nearby hills being completely evacuated, but also the river and riverbanks along an additional 314 kilometer or 195.1 mile long stretch of the adjacent Fraser River. Thus, a major disaster could soon occur, with the temporary lake expanding by nearly 13 million cubic meters a day, and please, and I mean this, do not let your curiosity get the best of you. The Chilcotin River downstream of the landslide is now completely dry. But at an undetermined time, a wall of water, perhaps upwards of 200 feet, could without warning sweep you away. So please do not go into the labeled sections of the Fraser and Chilcotin Rivers, meaning from Hanceville all the way to Hope, and evacuate if you are asked to. So, why did this landslide, which is centered 46.3 kilometers west-southwest of the town of Springhouse, occur in the first place? There is a short-term, a medium-term, and a long-term explanation for this. The long-term explanation is that a 3-kilometer-long patch of hillside extending 2 kilometers to the west and 1 kilometer to the east of the landslide which occurred on July 31st was already quite unstable. This is why there are 5 other obvious and presumably geologically recent landslide scarps which look like bites taken out of the hillside. As a result, the quarter square kilometer area which collapsed on July 31st was largely composed of loosely compacted and poorly sorted Triassic age limestone debris from earlier Pleistocene or Holocene landslides. And it goes without saying, landslide deposits are quite unstable and often collapse again. As for the medium-term cause, the ground in this landslide was previously largely held in place by the roots of tall conifer trees. However, in 2017, a major wildfire burned this hillside as part of what is known as the Hanceville Fire. Over the next several years, what remained of the burned trees rotted away, removing an important source of stability on the steep hillside. Then, while not particularly heavy, after 21 days of no rainfall occurring, this very hillside experienced rainfall for 8 out of 10 days between July 22nd and July 31st. In total, 2.1 inches or 5.33 centimeters of rain fell in this time span, which loosened the soil by just enough that it caused a major landslide to occur. While only 60 properties have been evacuated so far, there is a chance of a truly major disaster occurring, so I am keeping a close eye on the situation. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Sam Randall for supporting this channel.